Hello, everyone. I'm Pastor Jeff, and welcome to Mosaic Church of the Nazarene. Today, Dr. Cathy Miller will be sharing with us from the Word of God titled, God's Mercy. But first, please join us in some praise and worship music to glorify the Lord.
In the very thought of Jesus, His presence can be found. He's as close as the mention of His name. There is never any distance between my Lord and me. He's as close as the mention of His name. He's as close as the mention of His name. Jesus, Jesus, He's as close.
Today I want to share with you what the Bible says about God's mercy. We will look at different scriptures related to God and Jesus' mercy towards us. Let's start with the definition of mercy. The general definition of mercy is the compassionate treatment of those in distress, especially when it is within one's power to punish or harm them. God is definitely one with the power to punish us, but He chooses to be compassionate towards us, giving us compassionate treatment when we are in distress or when we commit sins. Mercy in the Bible relates to forgiveness or withholding of punishment. God showed mercy on us when He had His Son Jesus die on the cross to pay the price of our sins. God forgave us of our sins and withheld the punishment meant for us. Why would God do this for us? Because He loves us so much that He doesn't want us to be lost. We need to pray the prayer in Psalm 51, verse 1, which says, "Have mercy on me, O God, according to your unfailing love. According to your great compassion, blot out my transgressions." God also shows us mercy through His compassionate love by healing us, comforting us, and removing suffering from us. We can come to Him and ask for healing, comfort, and removal of suffering, and He will respond with His mercy, just as Jesus did in Matthew 17, verse 15. A man approaches Jesus and kneels before Him, saying, "Lord, have mercy on my son. He has seizures and is suffering greatly. He often falls into the fire or into the water." Jesus responds with His great mercy and compassion and heals and restores the man's son back to health. We have discussed that mercy and compassion appear to go together. However, they are different concepts. Mercy is the action of compassion. We first feel compassion towards a person who is sick or suffering. Then, if we act on that compassion, it is called mercy. Mercy is an action noun, but mercy is more than just caring and acting on that caring. It involves the concept of power. The person in power has the right to give mercy or punishment. Compassion International provides some good examples of mercy. An example of mercy occurs when you decide not to complain about your waitress's poor service in a restaurant. You, as the customer, have the power to punish the waitress or show her mercy. Maybe she is having a bad day and is usually a very good waitress. Your action to not report her to her manager is an act of mercy of kindness. Another example is not making it difficult for a person who offended you to apologize. This is the mercy of forgiveness. Likewise, correcting someone gently and not acting smug or vindictive is an act of mercy of grace. And helping a child escape poverty is an example of mercy of compassion. So what does the Bible say about mercy? Here are some scriptures that refer to God's mercy. Proverbs 28, verse 13, gives us some good advice. It says, "No one who conceals transgressions will prosper, but one who confesses and forsakes them will obtain mercy." This means if we confess our sins and forsake them, God will show us mercy and not hold our sins against us. We will not be punished for our sins. Isaiah 30, verse 18 says, "Therefore, the Lord waits to be gracious to you. Therefore, He will rise up to show mercy to you. For the Lord is a God of justice. Blessed are all those who wait for Him." This means we need to wait upon the Lord for His mercy and grace. It also reminds us that God is a God of justice, which means God can punish us for our sins, but he prefers to give us mercy instead, especially when we confess our sins to him, as Proverbs 28:13 said. Another example from the Old Testament is Lamentations chapter 3, verses 22 and 23. It says, "The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness." This is great news. God's mercies never end, and they are new every morning. Every day we can be refreshed with his gift of mercy instead of judgment. From the New Testament, we see Paul reminding us that God is rich in mercy. He told the Ephesians that out of God's great love, he loved us even when we were dead in our trespasses. He made us alive again with Christ, and by grace we are saved. Ephesians 2, 4, and 5. God loves us so much that he prefers to give us mercy instead of judgment. Thank you, God, for your mercifulness. Jesus also tells us to be merciful to others. In his Sermon on the Mount, he says, "Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy." Matthew 5, 7. We are to show others mercy if we want to receive God's mercy. Sometimes this seems difficult, but we must try. When we show others mercy, we are portraying God's nature. And because we want to be more like him, we need to show others mercy. Peter further expands on the gift of mercy. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 3 says, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead." We have new living hope because of Jesus' resurrection. He died for us, taking our place. This was the ultimate gift of mercy, taking the punishment that was meant for us. Thank you, Jesus, for this gift of mercy. So, to summarize, mercy is the action of compassion. It means the withholding of punishment by someone with a higher power. God has the ultimate power. He is the God of justice. So we are blessed to receive his mercy from his great love for us. He wants to show us mercy, and we can be like him by showing mercy to others. Let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you for your mercy. Thank you for withholding punishment from us. Thank you, Jesus, for your gift of mercy and taking our place of punishment. Help us to show mercy to others so that we may be blessed with mercy from you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
He said, "He's quite as alone."
Thank you, Cathy, and thank you everyone for tuning in to our midweek devotional. If you've been blessed by today's message and you're watching on YouTube, please give us a thumbs up and click on the bell to be notified of our future videos. Please join us at our next service. We welcome you and your entire family, and you'll find us right across from Skateland here on Dort Highway each Sunday morning at 10:30. We pray the Lord would bless you so that you then may become a blessing to others.